आई एम डॉक्टर जस्सी जॉन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनाटॉमी, यूटी विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एनाटॉमी ऑफ फीमेल जेनिटल सिस्टम. हियर वी विल स्टडी द इंटरनल ऑर्गन एंड वी हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर द सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द एनाटॉमी ऑफ द इंटरनल ऑर्गन ऑफ द फीमेल जेनिटलिया. नाउ वी विल स्टडी द सम पार्ट्स ऑफ some parts of the female genital system, and that is remaining in our previous video. Namaste, hamesha khush raho bitiya. So we have discussed female reproductive system is consists of some structures. These are the uterus, vagina, fallopian tube and ovary and external genitalia. And we have studied the structures of the uterus, the parts of the uterus, and we have studied how the uterus look like interiorly, and the relation of the uterus. We have studied position of the uterus and what is the structure of the uterus and what is the blood supply and lymph drainage of the uterus. We have studied. Now we will study also the all the supports, that is the ligaments. We have studied. And how it appear in pregnancy, we have studied, and we have discussed about the fallopian tube and parts of the fallopian tube, and what is the blood supply, what would be the arterial supply, vein drainage, and what will be the lymph drainage, and what could be the nerve supply. We have studied earlier in our video. Now we will study the vagina, anatomy of the vagina. It is a muscular tube that extends upward and backward from the vulva to the uterus, and it measures about 8 cm long, has anterior and posterior wall which are normally in opposition. At its upper end, anterior wall is pierced by the cervix, which projects downward and backward into the vagina. It is important to remember that the upper half of the vagina lies above the pelvic floor and the lower half lies within the perineum. Now we will see the interior of the vagina. The area of the vaginal lumen which surrounds the cervix is divided into four regions or fornixes. These are anterior, posterior, right lateral and the left lateral. Vaginal orifice in a virgin possesses a thin mucosal fold called the hymen, which is perforated at its center. After the childbirth, the hymen usually consists only of the tags. Now we will see the relations of the vagina. Anteriorly, it is closely related to the bladder above and to the urethra below. Posteriorly, upper third of the vagina is related to the recto-uterine pouch, and middle third is related to the ampulla of the rectum, and lower third is related to the perineal body, which separates it from the anal canal. Laterally, this relation of the vagina is the upper part is related to the ureter, and middle part related to the anterior fibers of the levator ani, and contraction of the fibers of the levator ani compresses the walls of the vagina together. Lower part, the vagina is related to the urogenital diaphragm and to the bulk of the vestibule. Now we will see the blood supply and lymph drainage of the vagina. Arteries, there could be vaginal artery, that could be a branch of internal iliac artery, and vaginal branch of the uterine artery. Veins, it form a plexus around the vagina that drains into the internal iliac vein. Lymph drainage, upper third of the vagina drains to the external and internal iliac nodes. Middle third of the vagina drains to the internal iliac nodes, and lower third drains into the superficial inguinal nodes. Nerve supply would be the inferior hypogastric plexus. What is the function of the vagina? It is not only is the female genital canal, but it also serves as an excretory duct for the menstrual flow and forms part of the birth canal. Now we will see the support of the vagina. Upper part of the vagina is supported by the levator ani muscles, and transverse cervical, pubocervical and sacrocervical ligaments. These structures are attached to the vaginal wall by pelvic fascia. Middle part of the vagina is supported by the urogenital diaphragm and lower part of the vagina, especially the posterior wall, is supported by the perineal body. Now we will study the anatomy of the ovary. It is 2 in number. Each ovary is oval in shape and each ovary measuring 1.5 into 0.5 inches. Our ligaments, there is mesovarium, suspensory ligament of the ovary and round ligament of the ovary. Side of the ovary, ovary lies against the lateral wall of the pelvis in a depression that is called ovarian fossa, and it is bounded by the external iliac vessels above and by the internal iliac vessels behind. Now we will see the capsule and ligaments of the ovary. Ovaries are surrounded by a thin fibrous capsule, the tunica albuginea. The capsule is covered externally by a modified area of peritoneum that is called germinal epithelium. And ligaments, each ovary is attached to the back of the broad ligament by the mesovarium, and part of the broad ligament extending between the attachment of the mesovarium and the lateral wall of the pelvis is called the suspensory ligament of the ovary. Round ligament of the ovary, which represents the remains of the upper part of the guberniculum, connects the lateral margin of the uterus to the ovary. Now we'll see the variable positions of the ovary. Rectouterine pouch, that is called pouch of the Douglas. During pregnancy, the enlarging uterus pulls the ovary up into the abdominal cavity, and after the childbirth, when the broad ligament is lax, ovary takes up a variable position in the pelvis. Blood supply, ovarian arteries arises from the abdominal aorta at the level of the first lumbar vertebra. And veins, the ovarian veins drain into the inferior vena cava on the right side and into the left renal vein on the left side. Lymph drainage that follows the ovarian artery are drained into the para-aortic nodes at the level of the first lumbar vertebra. Nerve supply would be from the aortic plexus and accompanies the ovarian artery. Now there are two assessment questions. These are: what is the anatomy of the uterus? You have to explain it in detail. And what is the anatomy of the uterus? Ovary. And it is also explained in detail. Thank you so much.